answer for yesterday's Kazi conundrum. The answer for yesterday's KC. The question was, if you missed it, the question for yesterday's Kazi conundrum was, Bilal radiallahu ta'ala, the illustrious Sahabi. We all know him, but what was the name of his father and what was the name of his grandfather? A double barrel question, and in fact, a bit of a trick question, quite a sly move by me. Nobody got the correct answer, people got half of it, but not the full thing. The answer is, Bilal radiallahu ta'ala's father's name was Rabah, because we know in Hayatul Sahaba and in the books of Ahadith, you must have read when his story is mentioned, where his biography is given. It's mentioned that Bilal ibn Rabah radiallahu ta'ala, I think Hazrat Shaykh Maulana Zakariya Sahib rahmatullah also in his book Hikayat Sahaba, which is the one that is read in our homes and in our masajid. I'm sure you've got that book, and I'm sure you do read it to your children every night before they go to sleep, which is what our scholars are encouraging us to do, so that our children understand who the Sahaba Kiram are and were, and they also understand who the ideal role models are. And inshallah, if we are presenting the example of the Sahaba Kiram in front of our children, in front of our brothers and sisters and family members, then inshallah we and they will aspire to be like the Sahaba Kiram, which we can never do, we can never equal them, but at least we can aspire to be like them. So inshallah then we will continue to improve and become better human beings and better Muslims as we continue to strive and continue to be like them. So they are our ideal role models. So as a Shaykh rahmatullahi, Maulana Zakariya Sahib rahmatullahi, in his book Hikayat Sahaba, he mentions a story, and it's been translated into English as well, as I'm sure you're all familiar, and in there it does say Bilal ibn Rabah was a Abyssinian slave. So from that we learn that his father's name was Rabah, Bilal bin Rabah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But we don't know the name of his grandfather. And that's exactly the point. The point that I wanted to emphasize is, Bilal was a nobody. He was a slave. He was born into slavery. All his life he was a slave, until Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala emancipated him and freed him. Up to that point he was a nobody. And had he not accepted Islam, then he would have lived his life as a nobody. Like his father and his grandfather, they are nobodies. Nobody knows them. They lived their lives. They were human beings, you know, and they had a life. And they were somebody, but history and people do not remember them because they did not accept Islam, therefore they did not shine. And Bilal radiallahu ta'ala, he was also a nobody. He was an Abyssinian slave. In the books it says he wasn't very good looking, he was very dark, and he was a slave. And yet when he accepted Islam, because of his endeavors, because of his sacrifices, because of his efforts, he became somebody. Not only did he become somebody, his name lives on till today. Do we not have children in our communities, in our madrasas, perhaps in our families, who are called Bilal, mashallah. So his name lives on and will live on, but the name of his father has died, and his grandfather is completely unknown. Nobody knows him. Nobody can even find out who he was. So that's exactly the point I wanted to make. Through Islam, not only did Bilal radiallahu anhu become somebody, but he became our master. He became our leader. He became our example, our idol. Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, or Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, these illustrious Sahaba, whom I mentioned last night when I came on the 5 o'clock slot, but I'll mention the incidents of from the lives of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu some other time, inshallah. But these illustrious Sahaba kiram, when they would call Bilal radiallahu ta'ala, they would say, Sayyidina Bilal, oh Sayyidina, oh my leader, please come, please sit down, oh my leader. So that is testimony to the fact that Allah Ta'ala gave respect and gave honor to Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was a slave, born into slavery, and would have died as a slave, as a nobody, but because he accepted Islam and he underwent great trials and tribulations and gave great sacrifices and made great efforts for Islam, to bring the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into his heart and to benefit mankind and to show other people the way. Therefore Allah ta'ala made him shine, and he shone in such a manner that he gained respect, and he has got this respect up to the day of judgment. In fact, after the day of judgment also, for eternity, Bilal radiallahu ta'ala is most honored and most elevated. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that, O Bilal, when I went for the Safar of Mi'raj, I heard your footsteps ahead of me. And in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam describes that on the day of judgment, I will be on the camel, and or I will be on the animal in Jannah, going into Jannah. Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu will be holding the bridle of that animal, and he will be walking ahead of me, and the two of us will enter into paradise. And the ulama-i-kiram, they say that because Bilal radiallahu ta'ala will be holding the bridle, he will actually step into paradise before or with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar, what an honor he was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That does not mean that he has a higher status than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it means that Allah ta'ala gave him this privilege and this honor, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him this high status and this honor and respected him. In fact, he was to have the honor of becoming the muazzin of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who could have a better voice than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who was better to give the azan? Who could be better to give the azan and give out the call for prayer than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself? But in his very lifetime, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam appointed Bilal radiallahu anhu. Oh Bilal, you give the azan. You will be my muazzin. So whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Medina, Bilal radiallahu anhu used to call out the azan. He used to say, "Oh Bilal, give us rest, give us solace." Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to find peace and solace in namaz. So when he was perturbed, when he was anxious, he would turn to Bilal and say, "Oh Bilal, give us some peace." Meaning, call out the azan. And so Bilal radiallahu anhu would give out the azan, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba kiram would go to the masjid to perform their salat. So Bilal radiallahu anhu was given this honor. In fact, on the conquest of Makkah, when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala is there, and Umar radiallahu ta'ala is there, and Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala who is there, and Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, and many, many prominent and many, many illustrious Sahaba kiram are present, yet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who does he command? Allahu Akbar. Who does he command to climb on top of the Kaaba? Allahu Akbar. He says, "Oh Bilal, climb on top of the Kaaba and give the adhan." What an honor, and what a day that was. What an honor he was given. What a status. So the whole point of the question was not just to ask you a question, not just to get us thinking, but also to derive some kind of benefit from that as well. So we learn a lesson from there, that Bilal radiallahu ta'ala's father's name was Rabah, and the only reason why we know his name is because Bilal radiallahu ta'ala was recognized by that, like it's like a surname. In those days they didn't used to have surnames, they used to say bin, son of or daughter of. So Umar bin Khattab, like that. So the only reason why we know his father's name is because it was like used like a surname. But other than that, his grandfather's name we don't know, and we will never know, which is the point that I've made. That the ulama kiram have made, that Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu was given honor, though he was a slave once upon a time, though he was black, and though he was Abyssinian. Amongst the Arabs, he gained prominence and he gained respect due to his efforts and endeavors for deen. So we also, dear respected brothers and sisters, if we also want to excel in deen, and if we also want to gain respect and a status in this world and in the akhirat, in the hereafter also, then we must hold fast to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to leave you with that thought. Inshallah, I'll be back very shortly. Please don't go away.